In today's game, you've got two extremely hungry ball clubs. I anticipate this to be a scrappy fight down to the end.
Opening tip controlled by the UAlbany Great Danes. No Cam Healy for Albany. He's got an oblique injury. He's missing his fourth straight. And no Adam Luca either for the third straight game. Different starting lineup today for Albany as Jamel Horton, who's making his first start of the season, went to the basket but couldn't put it in. St. Joe's, who loves to shoot the three. Jack Forrest will set it up out high for Bishop, driving the lane, drawing some contact and getting the roll.
When you watch today's game, especially on the offensive end that St. Joe's has it, look at the spacing. Everyone's outside the three-point line. You see ball movement, you see body movement, and when that happens, and you have the ability, it enables you to get in the gap and have penetration.
Jordan Hall feeds it to Funk. Trying to back down Doles, the fadeaway, and he hit it.
He made that look easy, didn't he?
Funk back to Hall underneath. Kick out for Bishop. Has to settle it down. Hall will take it from there. The three gets a friendly bounce it in.
When they have action, when they have cuts, when they have passes, when they have shifts of the offense, when you're going through defensively with the offensive guy, you can't slow up. Once you get inside, once they cut through inside the three-point line, because they're sprinting outside the lane.
Jamel Horton spinning, the behind-the-back pass, and the basket. And coaching wins, 90 of them came at Sullivan County Community College before he got the job in Albany. Now a four-point game, and the ball back to Albany. 7 minutes to go here in the first half. Strong move by C.J. Kelly, trying to navigate the traffic, dished it off, and the roll from Kellen Taylor. St. Joseph's supposed to be playing St. Louis. Albany's supposed to be playing Stony Brook. Both of their opponents have their programs on pause, so we get to watch them play each other as the block came from behind from Jarvis Doles on Taylor Funk attempt. And now right back the other way comes Albany. This is a two, and it's a tie game, courtesy of C.J. Kelly.
He completed the cut as well. He just didn't take three hard steps. He took as many as he needed to get open.
Jamel Horton from three answers for Albany. They've come close a few times as Demir Bishop knifes his way through and lays it in.
You know, you don't increase your followers by setting a solid screen, but your coach understands what you've done and gives you more playing time.
Funk swiped that one away on the pass intended for Kellen Taylor. And now it's Hall on the run. Spins himself into some space and banks it in.
If you get quick ball reversal, you'll 9 times out of 10 get an open look.
The spin from Forrest won't go. Nice move, the shot just a little bit off the mark, and now JoJo Anderson tries to take it hard, throws it out for a wide open three, and C.J. Kelly sticks it. But it bounced out on the try from Jamel Horton. Here's Funk from three. He's got his first three today.
I told you Funk wasn't going to be out too much longer.
Rizzuto with a good look, and hard foul. The basket counts, and Doles will go to the line. And Forrest with a rebound. Set it up for Hall again. He'll pull up. No, but the follow-up from Funk, and the foul. Nearly picked off. Instead, it goes through for another three from Rizzuto.
Rizzuto makes him pay. Jordan Hall thought he had the steal, shot the passing lane, but didn't get back in the picture, and Rizzuto made him pay. I wouldn't hold it and try to tie it. I would go as soon as I can and take the first good look, either two or three.
It's Kelly, and it's off his leg, out of bounds, and the ball to St. Joe's.
Hall makes a big-time defensive play. He turns it over on one end with the carry, but then gets a big defensive stop right here.
3 seconds, two. Rizzuto gets the three away, can't get it to go, and St. Joe's hangs on 67-64. And Billy Lang's club picks up their first win of the season.